Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Shrestham Manam Api Shachiputram Atrasvarupam Rupam Tasyagrajam Urupurim Maturim Goshtavartim Radha Kundam Girivarama Ho Radhika Madhavasham Prapto Yasya Pratita Kripaya Shri Gurum Tam Natosmi Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Atav Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagarna Raghunatan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakan Vitamstra Guru Vaishnav Bhagavan Tina Smarane Hoi Bigna Binashan Anaya Shri Hoi Nijavanchita Puran Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Speaking on Sri Vishnu Sahasranam, this isn't the most popular subject of my talks or of anyone's talks, but if anyone likes to hear these talks, and there is a following, so to speak, of those who are listening to these talks, means they have some taste for hearing about Krishna. That's good. That is desired. Vasudeva Katha Ruchihi. Name 985 is Atma Yoni. You all know what the word Atma means. At least theoretically, dictionary-wise, lexicographical understanding, in the words of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati. It's one of the commonly misunderstood words. Many people think Atma means Paramatma. Yoni is also a well-known word. It's a very important word in the Shakta tradition, especially the place of Yoni Puja, that's Kamakya, Guwahati. Yoni, Atma means the self or living being, or the Supreme Lord, there are various meanings, can mean the body, the mind, the soul. And yoni means the womb or the female genital. So what does all this mean as a name of Vishnu? Actually, the word yoni comes from the sense of causation, that which brings into existence. So Shankaracharya, the first commentator in this Kali Yuga on Sri Vishnu Sahasranama, brings out the aspect of Vishnu's function of creation. Here he takes that Atma, Vishnu, is the cause of everything. Upadana karanam na anyat iti atma yonihi. He's the upadana karana. You all know what upadan karan means if you study. Of course, you don't have that facility so much to study so much, but in Sankhya philosophy, there are two main causes. It's a big, big discussion, huge discussion. Two main causes are seen for the universe and everything. One is upadan karan, the ingredient cause, and nimitta karan, the agency cause. And the example given is, Mohan, you're nodding your head. No, the example is, the common example is given is of a clay pot. The clay is the ingredient cause, and the potter is the instrumental cause. And then there may be so many other sahakari karan also, just like, why does the potter make the pot? Because he's a potter in Vedic culture. You don't have to think about it too much, but that's his duty to do so. It's his means of income to support his family. Or then because someone has ordered such and such a pot. The machine is also a cause. The stick that he uses. So these are all, but they're two main ones. So Shankara brings out this reason. And then also another understanding is that he is the cause of all the atmas, in the sense that they all get their bodies, beginning from Brahma down to the grass or lower. All the great gods, they're all caused by him. Another meaning is that he is self-caused. Sambhavami Atma Mayaya. I come into being, I appear into this world, Krishna says, by my own energy, my own wish, my own desire, by my own maya, in the sense of illusion that people think he's an ordinary person. This Sambhavami Atma Mayaya, that could also be a very big study to understand this. One commentator, this Krishna Datta Bharadvaj, giving this meaning that Bhagavan has no other cause than himself, gives support from the Shruti, Shvetashvatara Upanishad, Savishva Krid Vishvavid Atma Yonihi. Which means that he is the maker of the universe and the knower of the universe, and Atma Yonihi. If you can take them as three separate terms. This term Atma Yoni comes up several times in Bhagavatam. In the third canto, Narayano Vishvasrig Atma Yonihi. In the word-for-word translations given in Srila Prabhupada's Bhagavatam edition, Vishvashrik, the creator of the universe, Atma Yoni, Srila Prabhupada gives as self-sufficient. He doesn't need anyone else to cause him. To get our body, we all need a mother and a father. But Vishnu doesn't. Although just coming up quite soon is the name Devaki Nandana, which might seem contradictory. That is to be discussed. In fact, I think I'll make a note now, so I don't forget that, because I didn't think of that yet. So, Devaki Nandana is self-caused, and Atmayoni, and the next name also, Swayamjata. Again in the Bhagavatam, there's a description which I don't really understand. It's something technical to do with the creation of the universe. I'll just give the translation that Srila Prabhupada has given. This is Canto 3, Chapter 8, Text 14. Atma Yonihi, this is translation is given as generating from the personality of Vishnu. What is being generated? It's the sum total form of the fruitive activities of the living entities who are at this stage unmanifested. And that pierced through the Lord's abdomen and took the shape of the bud of a lotus flower generated from the personality of Vishnu. So the lotus flower, which comes up from the navel of Vishnu, is the sum total form of the pending karmas of all the jivas who are to take birth. That's why, like I say, it's not understandable for someone who's been through a science education or any education. It's just something to be accepted. And it's saying this, Atma Yoni, by his supreme will, it illuminated everything like the sun and dried up in the vast waters of devastation. But mostly in the Bhagavatam, this term comes up quite a lot, Atma Yoni. It refers to Lord Brahma. And sometimes the translation is given as self-born. Or it can be understood he's born from Atma, from Paramatma. He's the firstborn, right? Brahma. Because Vishnu isn't born. Someone may say, well, the lotus was born before Brahma. But anyway, he's the firstborn active being in the universe. Regarding this Lord Brahma being born from a lotus, Srila Prabhupada talked about this in one lecture he gave. Srila Prabhupada said, long, long ago, I was talking with one Arya Samaji friend. He did not believe that a lotus stem can grow on the navel of Vishnu and there Brahma is born. Everyone says like that, mythology. It is not mythology, it is fact. So I asked him, here we see one coconut tree and about 60 feet above there is coconuts and there is water, there is pulp, and it is being carried from the ground. Where is the pipe? Where is the pump? How is the water within the coconut? Can you explain? He could not explain. And I said that even in material things which are in front of you, you cannot explain. How will you explain the spiritual position? How is the lotus grown from the navel of Vishnu? Therefore it should be accepted as inconceivable. Achintya kalu ye bhava natangs tarkena yojayat. Don't try to argue, it is foolishness, it is inconceivable. Now probably our biologists, chemists and physicists combined together with a lot of research can tell you how the water comes from the ground up to the coconut and produces pulp and all this and that. They can give some idea. They have to do a lot of research to find out. But how, why, they cannot explain. For someone trained in God consciousness, everything in the universe shows the existence of God. And for those who are opposed to God consciousness, everything in the universe points to the non-existence of God. Who is the real creator? Atma Yoni, we're talking about the source of all living beings. That's also Brahma can be called Atma Yoni because he appears to be the source of all living beings, right? From Brahma came the original living beings and then they created more. But Krishna reminded him who is the creator of all living beings. So Krishna just reminded him by performing a very sweet pastime of inciting Brahma to steal all his calves and friends, because after all he's within the heart of Brahma, and then producing them all again, showing that Brahma is the creator, but who's the real creator? Just gave him a reminder. Parashara Bhatta, who is the first Sri Vaishnav commentator on Vishnu Sahasranam, gives a very different meaning, because Sanskrit words can be explained in various ways. So he takes the root you to mean to unite, to mix, as in yoga, yoni, as in, so the same root, to unite. And he gives the example, dugdeneva, dugda. You all know what dugda means. Milk in Hindi, dud. Dugdeneva sitavalayam atmana bhoktaram mishrayati iti atmayonihi. Just like milk mixes with sugar very nicely. What's this got to do with Vishnu Sahasranam? Milk mixes with sugar very nicely, so it becomes like one thing and very tasty. So in the same way, he mixes with his devotees and they become so mixed up that both the milk becomes enhanced and actually it says here, mishri, sugar becomes enhanced, and they both become better by their mixing. I'm elaborating on this. The sweetness of mishri is better appreciated when mixed with milk, and milk becomes more tasty when mixed with sugar. So the Lord mixes with his devotees and it becomes very sweet. Parashara Bhatta, in his whole commentary, well, Shankara, in his whole commentary, is bringing out the majesty of Vishnu, and Parashara Bhatta is bringing out his soshilyam, how nice, how kind he is to his devotees, and his solabhyam, how he makes himself available to his devotees. So you can see this is very much brought out in Parashara Bhatta's commentary here. Baladev Vidyabhushan, the Gaurya Vaishnav commentator, gives a very similar meaning to the name Atmayoni as Parashara Bhatta does. He mixes Yoti, himself, Atma, with the devotees in the enjoyment of taste, and so on. And he quotes from Shruti again, Taittiriya Upanishad, Soshnute Sarvan Kaman Saha Brahmana Vipaschita. The liberated soul then enjoys all pleasures in the company of the expert Lord Hari. Name 986 is Swayam Jata, which you can also understand very easily. Swayam means by yourself, and Jataha means born. So it seems to be a very similar name, doesn't it? Self-born. Not created by anyone else. He appears by himself. He doesn't need any particular effort to do so. Parasya shakti vividhaiva shruyate swabhavaki jnana bala kriyacha. Everything is done automatically by his potency. So when he appears in this world, he just comes, that's all, as he likes. He's the cause of everything. Everything else that exists is an effect of him. He's the creator, everything else is created by him, but it's all play for him. His appearance is all play. We just had the name Atmayoni, and there are similar names previously. In Vishnu Sahasranam, Prajapati gives a similar meaning. Jana Janmadi, before anything was born, he was there. Aja, yeah. Yeah, that's there. Unborn. There are many names. Swayambhu, yeah. So Parashrabhata gives the name, meaning that. Yeah, so what do you do when names seem to have the same meaning? And then how, because you don't want to, explain and say that there should not be the punar ukti dosham, the fault of repeating the same thing. Some names come up twice, some kind of names come up three times. And then I just did a whole list of names with yagya, 12 names, yagya, yagyapati, yagya book, and so on. So the specific significance, Parashrabhata says, is that Swayamjat here means that he appears in this world as and when necessary, not that he's obliged to, but he feels obliged to appear in this world for the sake of his devotees, even without being called. Some examples of that, we can say the early avatar, if we see the dashavatar, Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, they're not called. Vamana, yeah, Aditi wanted. Then after that, we have Vamana, Ramachandra was called, but some of them, they just appear. Just, I've got something to do here. Mohini. But even Parashrabhata and the sub-commentators say that he takes birth out of his own will, out of his own compassion, without being called. And that even if the devatas come and pray for him, he in their heart is inspiring them to do so. Because his main concern is protecting his devotees and for all jivas. That's his very nature. He quotes in this regard, Name parthasti kartavyam trishu lokeshu kinchana nana vaptam avaptavyam varta evacha karmani. I have nothing to do in the world. Krishna's telling Arjuna, you want to not do anything, but you have to do. I don't have to do anything, but still I do. You should do your work, but even if you think you don't have to do your work, you should still do it, as I do, because you have duties. I don't have any duties, but still I work. There's nothing that I'm not working to get anything, I'm not lacking anything, yet I go on working. In his explanation of this verse, in his Gita commentary, Sri Ramanujacharya says that Krishna goes on working for the protection of the world, even though there's nothing for him personally to be achieved by that. Shankaracharya explained the previous name as signifying that Bhagavan is the material cause of the universe, and he explains this name, Swayamjata, as signifying that Bhagavan is also the Nimitta Karan. So everything is him, and he's also the cause of everything. He, in this regard, he quotes from the Brahma Sutras, Prakritischa pratignya drishtanta anuparodhat. You all understood that. No one can understand it. No one can understand unless it's unpacked by the commentators. unless the sutras are explained, no one can have any idea what it's all about. In the first sutra of the Brahma Sutras, Atato Brahma Jignyasa, well, the three of the words there are understandable, but the word Brahma, what is it? Well, that is the subject of discussion. And what is Brahma? And that is described in the next, Janmadyasya Yataha. And what exactly does that mean? Well, you can all say, probably, but if it hadn't been explained to us, we wouldn't have a clue what it meant. So the commentators, they explain it all. Radha Krishna Shastri gives the meaning that Swayam Jata is very similar to Atma Yoni, if you take it to mean who appears by himself. And he quotes from Taittiriya Upanishad, Tadatmanam Swayam Akuruta. Very clear that he himself takes birth by himself. If it's said that Devaki gave birth to Krishna, then Shukadev, he explains. We have in the Bhagavatam, Devakyang Deva Rupinyam Vishnu Sarva Guhashaya Avirasid Yata Prachang Dishindur Iva Pushkalaha. Then the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, who is situated in the core of everyone's heart, appeared from the heart of Devaki in the dense darkness of night, like the full moon rising on the eastern horizon, because Devaki was of the same category as Sri Krishna. So Krishna's in everyone's heart, but he entered the womb of Devaki, the womb. Then he came out when he chose. And the connection between Devaki and Krishna is like the connection between the eastern direction and the moon from which it appears. It appears that the moon rises in the east, but actually, on a cosmic scale, for the moon there's no east. Baladev Vidyabhushan gives a very nice understanding. Often he reminds us that it's Bhishma speaking. Bhishma says that he appeared in the land of Mathura. Vishnu appeared, Swayamjat, the complete Lord who appears according to his own will, together with all his expansions and all his qualities. So here we have this echoes Krishna's to Bhagavan Swayam. He's the original personality of Godhead, replete with all opulences, 100% Bhagavan. What do you think, Bhima Madhva? Any comments on that? Your Madhva pundits will beat us for saying that, won't they? They say you can't differentiate between any. They're all the same. There's no Krishna's better, Narayan, Vishnu, Rama. They're all the same. So we bow our heads on their feet and we'll go on speaking what we have heard from our acharyas. In this regard, Baladev Vidyabhushan quotes from Srimad Bhagavatam, Svashanta rupesh vitarai svarupair abhihardyamanesh vanukampitatma paravaresho mahadangsha yukto hiyajo pijato bhagavan yatagnihi. Being merciful toward his peaceful devotees, when they are oppressed by others of a terrible nature, the Supreme Lord, who is the master of the high and the low, although he is unborn, appears together with his powerful expansions, just as fire appears in wood. And now one very important explanation of Swayam Jata is that of his own accord, he appears to the devotee and removes the ignorance in his heart. He reveals himself to the devotee. Atah Shri Krishna Namadi Nabhaved Grahyam Indriyai Sivun Mukhe Hi Jivado Swayam Eva Spurati Adaha. Where is God? Where is he? He's everywhere, but we can't see him. He reveals himself, his name, form, qualities, pastimes, everything, as he likes, but he does so generally to his devotees. Atah Shri Krishna Namadi Nabhaved Grahyam Indriyai Sevan Mukhe. Those who are inclined to serve him, specifically said beginning with the tongue, because it's Namadi, by chanting the holy names. Or even if we're not inclined to chant the holy names, just if we take Krishna Prasad, it's another function of the tongue. So Krishna, Boro Doyamoy Koribare Jivajoy Shaprasad Anadilava. Now we just had prior to this the name Anna in Vishnu Sahasranam. So here I'm doing two names in one short session, and Anna I did one name in two sessions. So this way the commentary is going on. So much more could be said about this, but at this point I'm just going to say Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Thank you for so kindly listening. May Krishna reveal himself to you by your chanting of the holy names with a service attitude. Hare Krishna. Any question?
Hare Krishna. Hare Bhagavan. Guru Maharaj, when you were explaining yoni, and you said you to represent yoga, maybe I missed the ni.
That's the root, yeah.
Where you split the yoni into you to represent yoga, and then what does the ni stand for in that case?
That will be explained by the commentators. Well, that will be usually according to Panini grammatical rules. They'll quote some sutra, how it becomes yoni, yoga, yukta, how these words develop. They all come from the same root, but they develop according to Panini rules, which if you understand them, and if you don't, you don't. I don't think there's anyone here who understands, has been trained in that. Not me. Not you. Your forefathers would have been. Going back how many generations? Maybe three, four generations.
Three generations down, we had somebody who was a Ganapati.
Yeah, grammar is just their, for them it's just breathing. That's all. That's the very basis of what they're doing.
Anybody else?
We have our Gurukul teacher in Salem. He's trained in Chennai, Sanskrit College, from Smata background. So he's taking the boys up to a certain level in grammar. He's a very good teacher, But he says, if you want to go further, you have to go to someone else. That's as far as I go. Teaches them for about 2 years. And then further, then you have to find. So this is as far as I know. So Hare Krishna, any other question? Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna.